a flag throw folded by veterans from About Face Veterans Against the War. On behalf of the Poor People's Campaign, a national call for moral revival. We delivered that flag and a flower. The flower representing lives lost in this country and in this world because of poverty, racism, ecological devastation, militarism, war and violence. And we delivered a prayer with our demands. Demands that call for an end to the militarization of our society and our world, an end to warmongering, an end to violence from the powers that be. Demands for a ban on assault weapons and guns that are on our street.
It was a great honor to hand the flag to the representative of the senator from military personnel who had come to believe that the war that's going on now and have been going on for many years is fundamentally at odds with justice and with human values. We ask the representative of the senator to convey that on behalf of the Poor People's Campaign, a national call for moral revival, and on behalf of service personnel who have the position that we need peace and not more war. For what it's worth, she said she would convey that message. That's what we were here to do. And I'm grateful for the opportunity to be a part of this.
So now we ask those that are assembled that have flowers to come to the door of Senator McConnell's office and to leave your flower holding up those who have died. The 250,000 people who have died this year because of poverty. The 20 veterans who die to suicide every day because of the moral injury of war. The 9 million people across this world who die because of pollution. The 10,000 people who will be shot to death this year. So we ask people to start coming forward, to leave their flowers, remembering those who have died and those who have taken up the cause for justice. Those who have taken up the cause to build a peaceful world. As our nation takes time this week to celebrate Memorial Day, we are reminded by the veterans in this movement of the impact that militarism has on our communities here in the United States and around the world. We are reminded of the cost of war, and we come together today to speak the truth. That instead of waging a war on poverty, we have been waging a war on the poor at home and abroad.
That's right.
For the financial benefit of a very small few. We come together today to say that it is morally indefensible to profit from perpetual war. On this Memorial Day week, We push back against patriotic narratives that glorify war. Instead, we come here to condemn the military aggression and warmongering that has led to unnecessary deaths of service members and innocent civilians around the world. We come together to remember service members, their families, and all victims of war around the world who have died as a result of military aggression and warmongering. And we come today to raise awareness of the many causes and costs of war, so that our memorial proclamation becomes never again. Never again. Never again.
Never again.
Never.
It is with this promise that we remember those impacted by militarism and an immoral war economy. For all the people who have died in unnecessary wars, children and families from Afghanistan to Iran, Iraq and Palestine, because of our government's decisions to promote war instead of peace. Please say with me, we remember you.
We remember you.
For the children who have died from poverty, in a country where 53 cents of every federal discretionary dollar goes to military spending, and only 15 cents goes to anti-poverty programs, say with me now, we remember you.
We
remember you. For the slain women and children, the slain women and children who in 2017 made up over two-thirds of the civilian casualties from U.S. aerial attacks. Say with me now,
we remember you.
For the homeless veterans left to die on the streets, while in 2017 our nation spent $668 billion on the military. Please say with me.
We remember you.
For the countless families that go to bed hungry while the Department of Defense cannot account for $21 trillion in funds. $21 trillion in funds would be 235 years worth of SNAP. Say with me now.
We remember
our men.
For the Army Titans
in combat. This is your first warning. If you do not wish to be under arrest, please move beyond the officers, either down by the Russell Rotunda or behind me. The 20 veterans who died by suicide today.
Squeeze up.
And the 20 more who will die.
Perimeter, you're subject to arrest. So if you don't want to get arrested, you need to leave this area. Beyond the officers, where you'll see it, then it'll
all. Please stay with me now. We remember you. For the Say it with me now. We remember you.
By the children of Yemen, we're sorry to death.
I thought he said behind him.
We remember you.
You get a better shot now.
For Alton Sterling, Eric Rivera, Charlie Africa, Lakeisha Wilson, Sandra Bland.
All right, this is the third and final warning. The third and final warning.
Jr., who said, our only hope today is our ability to recapture the revolutionary spirit and go out into a sometimes hostile world, declaring eternal hostility to poverty, racism, and militarism. Dr. King also said that in the nuclear age, the choice before us is not
to be arrested.
Thank you. let's go ahead and stand on the roof.
Okay, we're going to go.